Hi everyone, welcome to this edition of the Hong Kong Interior Design and Construction Management course. Today we talk about hotel. Okay, let's get started. Actually, we talk about the China Hotel after the reformation and the opening up of China after 1980s. This content, we got the first Western hotel, China first Western hotel, foreign-related hotels. That's a type of hotels. Internal style, counter facility, etc. Let's talk about the first foreign hotel in China. This about around 100 years ago. You see, this is the old hotel, Tianjin, somewhere near Beijing. 1902 condition of the old hotel. Actually, it's built 1886 by Occident people. You see, this is the first Western hotel in China. It's the old condition. And after some time, demolished because it's very, very old. You see, 100 years ago, demolished and rebuilt to a new hotel like this one, on the same location, of course. We built a new hotel. This 2008, totally rebuilt. But the China government think this our old hotel is a memorial because it's the first Western hotel in China. So they want to rebuild it for its historical reason, you see. So this new building, they demolish it. And then we build the old building like this one. This is the new old building. Actually, this is a copy of the old building. They demolished the new building and rebuilt the old building, 2010. Now it's become a museum. Okay. After the reformation and opening up of China, there's a lot of Western hotel built in China. The government planned 300 hotels. 300 foreign-related hotels in China after 1980. So you see, this one's in Beijing. This two also in Beijing. This two. This one's by foreign architect. And this one's in Nanjing. It's done by Hong Kong Architectural Office. The interior design also done in Hong Kong. It's a Singapore investment. And this one in Shanghai. And this one is in Guangzhou. It's invested by Hong Kong merchants. Big one. Also this one in Guangzhou. Also invested by Hong Kong merchant. And also this one. Also in Guangzhou. It's built in the early 1980s. All five-star hotels. By foreign investment. Foreign architect and foreign interior designer. Okay, let's talk about the types of hotel in China. Of course, also this type of hotel all over the world. The first one, of course, is the city tourist hotel. It's the most common hotel. Businessmen and tourists lodge in those hotels. It's a city tourist hotel. And a business hotel, mainly for conference and business. Special hotel, theme park hotel, spa hotel, resort hotel, this is for holiday making, like this one. And near the seaside, you see. And spa hotel is a hot spring hotel, actually, like this one. It's a hot spring inside the guest room. And historical and cultural hotel, like this one. It's a Chinese historical style. Boutique hotel is like this one, luxurious. Service apartment is for long time lodging. Shin Hotel. Shin Hotel is an economical, mostly a two-star or three-star for young people or businessmen. Corporate identity. Ownership Hotel is maybe is unique in China. It's a kind of hotel that you can buy the guest room, investment purpose. I think this is very unique in China. Okay, we talk about the interior style, the most popular interior style. Like this one, five star is a European palace style. This is a buffet restaurant, and this is also in European style, most common. Traditional European style, and this is Mediterranean style. And this one is Scandinavian style, and this is in Chinese cultural style. Popular in China. Okay, we talk about the function allocation of a hotel. For those who have experience that live in a hotel, they know the common facilities in a hotel, you see. For this is the vertical section of a typical hotel. For the penthouse, there may be a president suite. And then guest rooms. Then there's a third floor. Mostly people, tourists, won't recognize there's a third floor. This is for the surface duct. There's many duct, vertical duct from the guest room, and then they make a turn here at the third floor. And then here is a gym, wellness, pool, etc. For this floor, there's a function room, conference room, business center, and then food and beverage. And then in the main lobby is a bar lounge, back of the house, retail shops, etc. For the car park, the basement, this is for the staff, the back of house, E&M, and car park. This is very typical. The typical vertical hotel section. If we do a hotel project, then it's most likely we will see this kind of chart as a summary of the facilities, you see. The total area, quantity, you see, and the square meter on each floor. This is a summary of the facilities. You see, back of the house, public and front desk, public toilets, retail and food and beverage. You make a summary of the facilities. In guest room, we have all kinds of guest room, like single, twin bed, double room. Double room is for the couple mostly, or family, and the suite, a double suite. We'll talk about later in this lesson. Okay, the heart of the hotel is the main lobby. You see, people did this is the entrance. You see, this lobby in cold region. 30 degrees Celsius difference outside and inside. People go in. This is the main lobby. Now this is the lounge, the bar lounge. This is a very big hotel. Maybe more than 700 guest rooms to 1,000 guest rooms. It's a very big, you see. Very big hotel. This is a restaurant. This is entrance lobby. We got the luggage and then the concierge. And this is the back of the house. Office, and there's a front counter, and then we got mostly shops and our toilet facility here, and the restaurant here. This design of the front counter is a lot good indeed. We should rotate this front counter to face the front door so that you can see the people coming in, and people coming in can see the front counter. So actually this design is a lot good, you see. Okay, food and beverage. Food and beverage is also important because the hotel have to earn money. You see, they also cater for outside customer, but they help to direct the hotel's business. It's a lobby bar lunch, you see. It's a lobby bar lunch, it's common. When they enter the hotel, we see the lobby lunch. Chinese restaurant, banquet hall, specialty restaurant, maybe it's Japanese, Korean, etc. This is the specialty. Four season restaurant, four season, maybe there's no definition of four season. What do you mean by four season? Food available for the all season. What they name four season? All day restaurant. All day restaurant means they serve all day from morning to midnight. Cafeteria is not a coffee shop, it's a buffet restaurant. You see, this is the layout of the typical Chinese restaurant. They also cater for banqueting. You see, this is a VIP room, you see. It's divided by operable partition. It's like this one, you see, here. We call it operable partition. It's a divider to make a VIP room, you see. Very flexible. It's the store here. This is the store of the partition. You can open like this for the function room and big restaurant. You see, this big function room or banquet hall, you can find operable partition like this one here. And this is the restaurant, mostly the cafeteria. To serve buffet or serve as a coffee shop. This is the entrance. And this is the entrance to the kitchen. And the receptionist maybe stand here. This is the workstation. And this is the bar. The bar, usually in a bar, you should have a band stage here, somewhere here. Nowadays, we won't make the pan counter like this way. Actually, we surround the column so people can sit around the bar counter. This is a bit English old style. For new style, the bar counter will surround the column, so four sides are available for the customers. Okay, we talk about rooms, guest rooms. For those people who have experience living in a hotel, they know there's a different kind of room as people require. You see, we have a twin bedroom. Twin bedroom is two beds. So the two person here, and a double room like this one. Double room is a big queen size bed or king size bed. It's mostly for couples. These are for two single person. This is mostly for a single person or couples. Type B, you see, this is also a double room. Type B, that's the design is different. You see, we got a jacuzzi here. And this is the suite. The suite means a sitting room and a bedroom for each guest room. We call it a suite, like this one. You see, when we go inside the guest room, there's a sitting room here, and then there's a bedroom here. It's different. Also, for this switch type A, it's an openable partition or a curtain to make the bedroom here. And then we got a sitting room here. This is what we call a switch. This is the floor plan, the general floor plan of a very, very big hotel. This is close to 1,000 guest room, you see. Two wings. Now, you see, this is the room type schedule of a smaller hotel. You see, the total is 112 rooms. We have a breakdown of the room types, you see. This table, you can see this table. Three bedroom, double room. We got all kind of D1 means D2 is the code number. R means the reverse. A mirror image. You see, like this one is a reverse. Like this one is almost a reverse. A mirror image. You see what I mean? Double room is switch one, switch two, double switch. Double switch is sometimes they got two bathroom or two sitting room. Or one reception room and then one sitting room. So you see what I mean, what they call a double suite. The management room, maybe a management room for the manager, is a kind of a big and luxury. Maybe also the basement guest room. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4 stories. So this is a breakdown of the guest rooms. So this guest room plans are actually contract drawing. You have a chance to look at the actual construction drawing of our guest rooms. It's a layout of the drawing. This is the layout plan, and this is the ceiling plan. Ceiling plan of the guest room. This is access panel, and then the lighting layout, and the AC layout. This is a maintenance panel, the access panel. You look at here, it's a bit different. You see, this wall, the original design by the architect, maybe is different. Maybe this wall is right here. The interior design has changed it to here, because we want to make this kosher, and kosher is the mini bar. So they have changed the design. They make the toilet a little bit larger. They relocate the wall here, so that there's a mini bar available, this space. Maybe the original design by architect, the walls are here, so right here. So they demolish the wall and make a new wall here. So it's a little bit changed by the interior designer. You see here, is the MCB board, the electrical distribution board. It's right here. The high inside is enclosure. This is the closet. And this is the surface duct. Also, this is surface duct. You see the pipes. The pipes go into this duct. This may be the air conditioner shaft, and this is the pipe duct. Okay, we talk about the star grading of a hotel. The stars of a hotel, five stars or four stars, etc. How they grade the stars. In China, is by this 14308 is a national standard. Yes, 2002 is the way of the grading of the star hotel. For 1 and 2 star hotel, there should be a front desk, front lobby, dining facilities, 75% of rooms with toilets, and then 3 stars. Yeah, in between ones, function room, suites, you should got suites for 3 stars hotel. For 4 stars hotel is you got Western hotel, restaurant, shops, business center. For one or two star, maybe they don't serve 2 languages. Maybe they use only 1 language. For 3 stars, they must use 2 languages, English. The Western hotel, shop, business center, so it's different. Either for 3 star hotel or 2 star hotel, they won't get a business center, but for 4 star, there must be a business center and recreational facility, luxury suites and recreational facility for 4 star. For 5 stars, there must be a swimming pool and 800 square meter function room, minimum 800 square meters function room. So 5 stars are different. For most hotels, they cannot achieve 5 stars because they don't have a swimming pool. That's why most hotels are 4 stars. Only a few achieve the 5 stars and standard. And there's another system by the Tourist Association in China. They rate the stars by marks. You see, 180 mark, 5 stars, 300 marks. And how they calculate the marks is like this. At this table, you see, ballroom, they got a ballroom, then 2 marks. KTV room, chess and card room, 1 mark. Games room, 1 mark. Library, 1 mark. Bookstore, 1 mark. So the facility, more facility, they got more marks. Now this tax diagram show the proportion of different of 5-star hotel. That's the number. The number proportion of star hotels is 1-star, only a few 1-star, and 5-stars is here. And most common is the 3-star hotel, you see, is the majority. 3-star hotel and 4-star and 2-star and 3-stars are the majority of the hotels. Of course, different countries have different grading system. Usually based on decoration, facilities, management, and services. Okay, this will end our brief description of China modern hotel design after the 1980, after the reformation and opening up of China. So, thank you for watching. See you again.